Good morning and welcome to 3 Minutes on Markets and Money. I'm your host, Lance Roberts, talking a little bit about, well, this rally we've had over the last couple of days has been nice. We came down and actually held that 50-day moving average as we talked a little bit about yesterday. But unfortunately, we also rallied yesterday right back into the 20-day moving average and failed there. This has been providing some pretty important support here for the markets in the short term. And this is occurring at a time where we have a money flow sell signal intact. And again, as you know, where we got the sell signal was also where we triggered a MACD sell signal. This has put downward pressure on the markets. As we've talked about in our newsletter, we said that this was going to apply some pressure here. Now, importantly, as we've talked about before, these money flow sell signals don't necessarily mean that the markets are going to crash. Sometimes they do. Sometimes they don't. And right now, the market's been kind of acting normally relative to having this money flow sell signal intact at this current time. And that's been this consolidation pattern, as we've been talking about here over the last few days. Now, the market today is going to try to open up here a bit at the open. We're going to try to get above the 20-day moving average. It'll be important that if we want to see this market rally back towards the previous highs, we're going to have to get above this 20-day moving average and hold that through Friday. Otherwise, a move above this that fails before Friday simply keeps us back in this consolidation range. Now, the more important aspect is that we have to continue holding this 50-day moving average. A break below that 50-day is going to very quickly bring the 200-day moving average into focus. Now, I don't expect that to happen just yet because, again, this consolidation here has been basing right along the 50-day moving average. We keep finding buyers right at that level, particularly in the tech stocks, importantly here. So we'll see what happens here over the next couple of days. But Friday is important from the standpoint that if this market's going to gain traction as we head into the month of October, it's got to get above the 20-day moving average and hold that. Now, as I stated, these money flow sell signals don't always mean the market is going to have a big correction or a crash. In fact, as we've seen here over the last couple of months, these money flow sell signals have corresponded with markets that simply trade sideways, consolidate, and then once the buy signal triggers, then we get an upward move in the market. The next sell signal leads to another consolidation, and the following buy signal leads to the advance. So this has kind of been the stair-step pattern that we've now seen here over the course of the last several months, really ever since we saw this back in the March lows. But again, don't dismiss the fact that these sell signals can be important because, again, this money flow sell signal triggered in February just before the crash in March. So sometimes a sell signal is more than just a sell signal, as they say. So again, be a little cautious here. As the markets are consolidating here, we are getting kind of oversold on a short-term basis. This does suggest we could get a rally in the markets here over the next couple of days to weeks. Just manage your risk accordingly. We are certainly very extended here. And as we move into the election, volatility risk are definitely picking up here. I'm your host, Lance Roberts, for 3 Minutes on Markets and Money. We'll see you tomorrow.